Good day, everyone. Before I start talking about this project, I just want to address that I just reached 100,000 subscribers, and I want to thank each and every one of you for helping me to reach this milestone. It's really cool and motivating for me, and I have great plans for this year when it comes to this channel. So here you can see me design the turtle, which I'm going to try to make in this video. And the turtle itself is going to be made out of birch wood, pretty boring type of wood. And the shell is going to be covered with birch burl wood, which is a lot more interesting. It has a very random but cool wood structure. And I can already tell you that I'm pretty sure I'm going to change the shell design as I start creating it, because as it is right now, it's going to be really hard to make all the pieces fit together nicely. I would be able to do it, but it would just take so much time. So now this design is finished. Let's glue it onto a piece of wood and start carving it. So after I was finished cutting this on the bandsaw, I noticed a pretty big defect in the wood. It's actually running straight through it like this. And yeah, I just hope I can remove enough wood so that the problem would go away. And that would probably require me to make the wings further down than I had planned to. But it might actually look better that way than what I actually was going for in the first place. So here I'm using my Merlin 2 grinder, and I actually ended up almost killing this machine in this project, because I was applying excessive pressure to the wood when I carved, and it clearly states in the manual that you should not apply excessive pressure or jam the wheel. So yeah, it started coming smoke out of it and stuff, but it survived. But I'm afraid it might give up on me pretty soon, because maybe something inside of the motor is destroyed or something. So that's just a tip to other guys out there, just let the machine work itself, so you don't ruin it, because yeah, it's a pretty expensive tool. I actually became more and more optimistic about the defect in one of the wings as I was carving, because I actually managed to remove most of the dark area. And I was originally afraid of that the defect would be so deep that it would actually almost break off the wing. But as you can see, I think it's going to go pretty well in this project. So actually, I have to be honest with you guys and tell you that I did not have my full heart invested into this project. I think the reason is that I actually made this design based on the thought that I wanted it to be cool, not that I just wanted to make it myself. So take for example my previous video where I made a saber-tooth tiger. That was actually a design I really wanted to work on myself, and when I do it that way, everything becomes so much easier. So that's just a note to myself for my next project, to take more time with the designing phase and really go for something that I want to create myself. I had to do this step after I did the carving of the wings because I only have a very thin blade for this contour saw, and it wouldn't be able to cut through the thick piece of wood in the start of the project. So now I'm about to apply the first coat of oil to this turtle. I'm using Danish oil. And the area where the defect was previously had a really nice grain structure to it, as you can see when I apply the oil over that area. So here I started what was I gonna say? I'm gonna start to cut up the pieces for the shell of the turtle. And you can see here, it has such a beautiful wood grain, and this is birch burl, which I was talking about in the start of the project. Before I started shaping this small bricks to the shell, I expected it to be fairly easy, but to be honest, it was quite a nightmare, and I had to go back and forth so many times to make it fit correctly. And this was just one piece out of, I haven't counted, but maybe 20 in total. So it was really hard to make it fit correctly to the shell I had already made. So here is the method I decided to use to make the bricks for the shell, and I made them fit fairly well, but it's a little it's a small area between the shell part and the bricks, but I think when I glue all the pieces together at the end, it's gonna produce a pretty cool result. And the bricks are actually thick enough, I think, to hide some of the bad fittings I made, so that's really good. I should have used a lot more time on the measuring for these parts, because what you can't see here is the countless hours I used here to make these bricks fit, and I can't complain enough about how tough a time I had. And after many hours, I actually managed to finish all the pieces, and now these are gonna be hand sanded and stained brown. When I apply the stain to this small patch of burl, you will see how much that magnifies the structure of the wood. You can still get a really nice effect just oiling these burl bits, but I wanted to make them pop out from the rest of the turtle, and I think this is a really good strategy to get a nice effect like that. So after letting the stain dry for 10 minutes, I dropped them all into Danish oil, and as with the turtle, I'm gonna oil these parts 4 times. And I let them soak in the oil for 2 minutes before I dry off the excess oil. So here I am about to finish off this project, and I'm going to use quick setting epoxy to glue on the pieces to the turtle shell. I should have waited a few minutes to let the epoxy set a little more, because as you can see, some of the bits wouldn't stay where I put them. So, and that made me spill some of the epoxy, but it can be sanded away later, and I'm going to do that. And I will also try to buy some walnut wood to make a plaque for this turtle to stay on, because I think walnut has a nice color and would be a really nice contrast to the turtle itself, and also match the color of the shell of the turtle. So here is the result of this project. It turned out to be a pretty cool piece of art in the end, actually. So I want to thank you all for watching, and I hope I can show you another project not so long from now. So take care, everyone, and goodbye.